Good. So there are also other issues, right? It's not just about bias. There are also other ethical issues. Like, for example, AI can totally be used to improve, in quotes, weapon systems. So now imagine if suddenly a war would happen and you have a machine which is enabled to do a kill-no-kill decision automatically based on whatever algorithm. Okay? I know I don't want that. Probably nobody wants. There are countries who are already, you know, we don't really know, but we suspect strongly that they have these kind of systems in place. All right? Now here in the West, we have checks and balances in place still, so we're okay so far. We don't know how long. Okay? Can totally be used to spy on people. Okay, we have face recognition, we have classification, we have detection of suspect behavior, which of course you have to ask yourself, oh yes, but who said that this behavior is suspect? All right, suddenly you don't want to have one person deciding that my behavior is suspect based on whatever, you know, rule. Okay, so that's dangerous. We have deepfakes. Now deepfakes are really interesting because they can lead to great things. And by the way, if you're interested, check yesterday, there was a trailer that was published. If we have 5 minutes at the end, I'll show you. About DALL-E. And basically, they took a picture of DALL-E and they animated it. And they are going to apparently do a whole exhibit around that, which is amazing. It's like a moving picture, like Harry Potter, you know? But of course, it can also be negative. And here is an example. So this is Obama. Sorry for the sound quality, it's not very good, but basically it's Obama speaking, or so you would think, right? But actually it's not. And so what happens here is that with this system, you can have a fake president of the US saying anything, literally. And if you have somebody who can fake the voice in a convincing manner, like the, when I cut, it was going to an impersonator who was able to fake the voice of Obama, it means that literally we can have them say anything, okay? And we can even synthesize voice in a, you know, fairly accurate manner. So what it means is that these days, with the power of AI that we have, you cannot trust, well, we knew that you cannot trust news for sure. We knew that you cannot trust pictures, okay? Now we know that you cannot trust videos. You cannot trust anything you see. You need to double check everything. And let's face it, who is, you know, who is doing that, right? Most people are just lazy and accept that it's going to be accurate. So this is an issue. Privacy, of course, privacy is a big issue with AI because we use huge amounts of data. So in Switzerland, in Europe in general, we follow GDPR, which is already you know, a good step. But of course, it's a worldwide issue, right? And so you need to absolutely respect the customer's choice. If the customer tells you, you may not use my data to train an AI, you shouldn't use the data to train an AI, even if that data has been anonymized. In fact, it's even stronger than that. You should ask for permission. If you don't ask for permission, you should assume that they don't want. Okay? So don't use personal data for these kind of things, and especially don't leak personal data, and that can be like directly, I'm going to just leak the, you know, my personal data, or you're going to leak my sister's personal data, which by inference says something about me, okay? So you need to be, basically it's a big no-no, right? You shouldn't do that. And you should make sure that the AI that you're creating is complying with those. So you should have guidelines in place, not just for humans, but also for the AI, which is something new, okay? So this is an example a few weeks ago, I think it was 4 or 5 weeks ago, this came out, and this is an application called Ever, an app on the phone, which people were using a little bit like a photo album. They were taking pictures of their kids, and then they were kind of tagging them and sending to the picture. And then suddenly the firm decided to use this data to train a facial recognition AI. And when they got caught, and that's really the bad part, right? Doing that is already bad. But when they got caught, the CEO said, oh, but it's no problem because we are not publishing this data. So they don't get it. They didn't get it. You should not train an AI with data without asking people first. That's like as simple as that. In the US, there are about 50% of the population which is already in facial recognition networks. So it's already too late. We lost that battle already in some places, okay? That's something like 117 million of people. And they use this data, for example, to grant you access to a plane, or these kind of things. Okay, so you need to be super careful with that. So you need to respect the right of customer. Okay, we know that with GDPR, we need to provide them a way to remove the data. We need to stop the nagging, which now does even more nagging because you have the, do you want to accept those cookies? And then they keep asking you, right, because they are super scared to be fined. That's bad too. So privacy is even more important, and really AI has to comply.